Power BI recently got an update that makes it so much more office-like, right? So the visual editing experience is very similar to when you edit charts in Excel. I had a chance to test it out, and I'm going to share some hidden tips I came across. So first of all, this is currently a preview feature. To turn it on, you need to go to File, Options, Preview Features, scroll down until you see On Object Interaction. Place a check mark here and click on OK. Now you need to restart Power BI and you're going to see a different interface. Okay, so I've opened up a file that already has some data imported and I immediately notice a difference. I have a lot more space on my canvas. That visualization pane is gone. Where is it? It's up here. Well, not only here, because there are different ways you can add a visual. You can either just click on this and it immediately inserts a visual. You can select a visual of your choice. You also have the ability to right mouse click and add a visual, or just like before, you can start off by selecting the fields that you want to create a visual on. So let's say sales value, I'm just going to drag and drop it here and it immediately inserts a visual. Now the new default visual for numeric fields is a card. Okay, let's remove this one and bring this to the side here. Immediately, I notice these two new options. This is similar to the chart experience in Excel, and these are contextual depending on the visualization that you've selected. You have the ability to build on this visual and format the visual. Now let's say I don't just want to take a look at sales value, but I want to take a look at it by department. I can click on Add Data and go and grab department. I'm just going to select it, and it's automatically going to add it here. And it immediately changed my chart type. It changed it to a bar. Notice this button is turned on for suggest a type. Now, if this really bothers you, you can turn it off. You'll see a similar interface to what we had before. And if you find yourself turning this off every time you're inserting something, you can turn it off by default in options. Now, I personally prefer to have it on. But now let's say I don't want a bar, I want to change this to a column chart. You can do that from here. Don't do it from here because if you select a chart type from here, it's going to add a new chart. Now we don't want that, we just want to edit this chart and all the editing is done directly here. To view the other chart types, just click on this dropdown and you get the full list. Now let's go ahead and add date. Instead of add data, I'm just going to click on this and drop it in here. That works as well. Notice my chart changed to a line chart. Now let's talk about the different formatting options we have. So remember, this is contextual depending on the chart type we've selected. You can easily turn features off. So let's say I don't want the y-axis, I'm going to turn it off. I'm going to add markers, data labels, series labels. Let's also turn off the legend. This interface makes adjusting chart elements super easy. If you don't find what you're looking for, click on More Options and you're going to see the format pane open up on the side. Now, if you scroll down, you're going to see that the features we had in the analytics pane, like trend line, reference line, and so on, are here now in the format pane. Now, one other cool option is up here for title. So if I expand this and scroll down, I have the ability to turn on the subtitle. So take a look at my title. Maybe I find it to be too long. I want to split it into two separate lines. I'm just going to turn it on and now I have a subtitle. I also have the ability to add a divider just to visually separate my title with my graphic. Okay, so let's expand this. It has more space to breathe. Now also notice that on the sidebar here, I have the format icon and I have my data, so I have the ability to switch between these. If you happen to close format, for example, and you want to bring it back, you can of course go here, click on more options, but you don't have to. You can go to the view tab here and bring back your format pane. You can also add different panes as well. So let's say you're working with bookmarks, you can add it here and you can easily switch between them. Now, a hidden tip is that if you want to add more panes to the side, so let's say you're working on a big screen and you can sacrifice some of your canvas space, you can easily do that by right mouse clicking and opening in a new pane. So this opens up my format options separately beside data. I can also do that for bookmarks, right mouse click, open in new pane. Okay, so right mouse click is your friend here. Talking about right mouse clicking, the easier way to format a chart is to right mouse click go to Format. You're going to get this blue border with squares on the sides, and this means that you're in Format mode. Now, a faster way of getting to Format mode is just to double-click on your chart, and now I'm in Format mode. What happens here? Well, now I can easily right-mouse click on any series or any element here and format it. So, for example, I can easily adjust the line color, or I can format my values. I first select them, right mouse click, and I get my formatting options here. I can make them bigger or adjust the way they're shown. Let's say I want to remove the year. I'm going to select it and press delete. I want to adjust my title. I'm going to select it and just select it again. You're going to see it bigger in this box and adjust it as you need. Right, so as long as you're in format mode, the default behavior of Power BI is deactivated, right? Because usually when you hover over these or you click on these, you end up cross-filtering your report. And that doesn't happen if you're in format mode, which you can easily get to by double-clicking. Now, this type of on-object formatting is currently supported for bar, column, line, area, combo, and scatter charts. Now, one last thing before we wrap up. If you're looking for your canvas options, you can right-mouse click on the canvas and select Format Canvas. You're going to find your canvas settings here and your drill through settings under Page Information. So that's the new Power BI object experience. Obviously, these are the early days, and there are going to be a lot more visuals that will be supported in the future. And the experience is only going to keep improving based on our feedback. So let me know what you think of this and if you find it better than it was before or not. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet, and I'm going to catch you in the next video.